A murder scene. Investigators discover huge amounts of blood everywhere. The blood of the victim, but possibly of the criminal as well. From tiny traces, today's investigators can quickly identify a potential culprit beyond any doubt. It's only possible when DNA evidence in the test tube is amplified billions of times over. The essential feature for DNA amplification is an enzyme that can be found in all cells, including our own. The DNA polymerase. It's a diligent copying machine. Every time a cell divides, the DNA polymerase creates an exact replica just beforehand of the complete genetic material, that is, the DNA. The original and the copy then divide, one-to-one, into new daughter cells. And this principle can also be employed in a test tube. To read the DNA, the mixture is first heated and then cooled down again, 30 times over. During this process, the tiny amounts of DNA are amplified billions of times. It's a real chain reaction, and that's how it got its name. The polymerase chain reaction, or PCR for short. It forms the basis for research into genetic diseases, ancestry, or even forensics. But PCR also has its weak points.
La PCR, podríamos compararla con la...
You can compare the polymerase chain reaction with an old photocopier, because lots and lots of single steps are needed before the complete DNA ends up being amplified.
La amplificación del DNA.
What the pioneering researcher Margarita Salas is saying is that if we compare PCR with copying technology, it's a bit like an old photocopier from the 1970s. Instead of making copies of all the genetic material, it can only produce copies of one single page. And even within that page, the text starts getting harder to read. After about 1,000 letters, it's virtually illegible. Margarita Salas, now 80 years old, changed genetic research forever. Here at the Centro de Biología Molecular Severo Ochoa in Madrid, she's been researching and teaching for over 50 years. It's no coincidence that her institute is named after a Spanish Nobel Prize winner.
I got to know Severo Ochoa when I finished my third year studying chemistry. At that time, I heard one of his lectures and I was fascinated. That was even before I studied biochemistry. He promised that once he returned to New York, he would send me a biochemistry book. And that's just what happened. He sent me this book here, General Biochemistry, with his own personal dedication to me.
With this book, Severo Ochoa ignited Margarita Salas's passion for biochemistry. Ochoa would go on to win a Nobel Prize shortly afterwards. In 1964, Salas also promptly followed her mentor to the United States. It was an exciting time, because just 10 years earlier, the structure of DNA had been discovered. Suddenly, everything seemed possible, including unlocking the secret of life itself. In 1967, Margarita Salas brought genetics back home. In Madrid, she and her husband established the first professorship of genetics in Spain.
When we returned from New York to Madrid, it was like coming back to a kind of scientific no man's land. Molecular biology hadn't established itself in Spain at all. We wanted to change all that and teach the subject there. That was when we decided to investigate the bacteriophage Phi-29, a bacterial virus, because it was small and hadn't really been researched at all.
Salas devoted all her energy to researching the bacteriophage Phi-29. The virus is harmless to humans. Over decades, Salas gradually uncovered the secrets of the virus, not only of its molecular structure, but also its genetic background. and Salas suddenly found herself fascinated by one of its 20 genes, because she realized that the virus had its own DNA polymerase. That placed it in a class of its own.
We examined the properties of the DNA polymerase and discovered that we were dealing with an extremely efficient enzyme. That is, it starts synthesizing at one point of the DNA and carries on doing so to the very end without interruption. That was when we suddenly realized that the properties were extremely suitable for use in biotechnology.
Going back to the metaphor of the photocopying machine for a moment, a geneticist's everyday life suddenly looked very different from before. DNA amplification was far more efficient now, thanks to the copier known as Phi-29 Polymerase Deluxe. This one was finally able to copy not just one page, but 15 of them, all at once, without any problem. There were also far fewer copying errors. And Salas's polymerase also functioned at a comfortable temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Unlike the usual DNA amplification technique, where the test tube containing the polymerase had to be heated and cooled many times over, Salas immediately filed a patent application for her technique.
The Phi-29 DNA polymerase also turned out to be extremely profitable in economic terms. As the holder of the patent, the Spanish National Research Council generated royalties of 6.6 million euros for as long as the patent was in force.
All the income from Salas's patents goes to the Spanish National Research Council and also flows into her work, because today she is still passing her knowledge on to the next generation of researchers. They're all working together with her on a future that began a whole 50 years ago, when a biochemistry textbook just happened to end up in the right hands.